This is the story of my senior year of high school and how it destroyed my life.
Your father and I want to talk to you about something sad. Rachel Kushner has been diagnosed with leukemia.
That sucks.
It sucks.
It sucks quite a bit.
Dad, Cat Stevens is calling me.
Well, he's deeply distraught.
I identified with Greg, identified with this lost teenager, trying to understand these very abstract feelings and emotions and how he was going to express that. So I saw it as a way to deal with something quite serious through humor.
You might be someone who could make Rachel feel better.
I don't need your stupid pity.
I'm not here because I pity you. I'm actually here because my mom is making me.
It's actually worse.
This script came to Alfonso at a time in his life where he just lost his father, and he decided this movie should be about opening your eyes to life.
Me and my dad used to walk around the block and count squirrels. Squirrel, 7, 2 squirrels, 9.
Jesus. You need to apply for a dad refund immediately.
My dad had the weirdest sense of humor on earth, and that's the best way to pay tribute to him.
Please appreciate how honest that was just now.
Alfonso was very open with me about why he wanted to tell the story. We had developed this really deep trust with each other, and I wouldn't have succeeded the way that I did if it weren't for him.
One thing you can do if you don't want to talk to anyone is just enter a subhuman state. Pretend you're someone annoying.
Oh, hi, Rachel. I'm really sorry you have cancer.
That's exactly what I'm talking about.
He will push you and give you a direction here and there without you even knowing it, so you think it's all coming from you, but really, he's just pulling all the strings, this grand puppet master.
Who is this little friend?
Earl's just my coworker.
I've known him since kindergarten.
What you got, cat? Wanna fight? Didn't think so, punk-ass cat.
So you and Greg are coworkers?
Nah, we friends. Dude's terrified of calling somebody his friend. Dude's got issues. Alfonso showed me how to bring it down, because at first I was just like, okay, Earl is like, ah! He was like, no, Earl is not like, ah! He's just like, ah. He made it a very cool character to play.
How are you coworkers?
We make films.
Movies?
They're terrible.
The idea behind each one was we took a film that we liked and we made the title stupider and then made a new film to reflect the new title. It's a formula that only produces horrible films, but for some reason we keep using it.
Alfonso is a scholar of films. Like, he's really a film fan. You know, he has more movies than any of us.
Throughout his whole career, you know, he's been mentored by some of the greatest. He's been mentored by Scorsese and Iñárritu, Nora Ephron. He's been on their sets and he's worked with them. But it's all about the truth that he brings to the story that drew us to him as a filmmaker.
He's got a plan, but when it actually comes down to figure out what he's gonna do on the day, he's able to kind of move and shape and try and find these moments.
Action.
It was just amazing to watch him sort of develop this idea and utilize everybody around him.
You can change lenses, please, a little wider, one wider.
He has an incredible skill of being visually talented and knowing how to work the cameras and lighting and making it visually beautiful. And then on top of that, he's really funny.
You want to help, you're going to take this girl out to get some ice cream. And me too, because I love that shit. You like ice cream?
Yeah.
Let me see a fake punch, slow motion. Okay.
He just comes at everything. He wants to be totally new and totally unique.
You guys were making a movie for me.
I found this movie as an opportunity to express myself through Greg and do it through images and color and sound and humor, more importantly.
High school is the mouth of a great demon biting and chewing and smushing people in the face.
The process of making the movie itself was very healing.
I'm so tired of you treating this girl like she a burden. Because somebody actually cares about you, her life is over after this.
Life can keep unfolding itself to you just as long as you pay attention to it.